It feels like a kind of gift to be able to really focus on someone, particularly for any continued length of time. Mothers do really gaze and stare at babies, and certainly vice versa. And people do at certain times in their life. But to, in a way, formalize it by having someone sit for me so that I can look at them and try to comprehend something and bring that into, a piece of charcoal rubbing on the paper. It seems a very wonderful and special thing to do. The human face is so extraordinary, really, in a way, every human face. And I have drawn occasionally people on trains or in subways who would be called, I guess, really unattractive, maybe even ugly. But it always seemed to me that when I spend any time drawing them, that that aspect, that judgment disappeared completely. And I was often amazed to find just, the wonder of the face itself, the expression, the life in the face. There's one man I've drawn probably the most. His name is David Lawless, and he was an artist, and I met him because he was hitching on the road in the country, often with a coffee cup that he had been carrying up a hill for a long time. And I could draw him for many, many years, really. I mean, I would always find, I know, something that would be very compelling to me. I mean, I never knew him when he was younger, but obviously you can see so much has happened to him. But for me, it's almost like drawing maybe a canyon, a great geologic place or form that's just, I just have to move a centimeter and it all changes. It's all. The structure is so vital, there's so much going on. Peter Matheson, who's a friend, wonderful writer, naturalist, and also Zen master, and who's meditated for a lot of his life. Sad, that's him. And he sort of made a little, I can't do it, but he made a little gesture and anchored himself into the chair, and I thought right into the ground. And but it looked like he could stay there for maybe a year, and he wouldn't be tired, he wouldn't, need to wiggle around or anything. So people bring, they bring their life with them, of course. this painting drawing is actually called Looking at Velázquez. And it's based, of course, on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 heads, in this case, the whole figure, from Velázquez. And the dwarfs interested me a lot. I felt he had a lot of freedom with them that he couldn't quite have with royalty, of course. I mean, it wouldn't be permitted. Whereas the dwarfs were accoutrements for the court to show up the supposed beauty and perfection of the aristocracy. But the dwarfs have an amazing humanity, and I find them very, very touching. And I think in more recent time, I've been, not surprisingly, more interested in drawing older people. Certainly have drawn lots of young, beautiful women, men, children. And the face that's lived through a lot and with a lot or without a lot is very interesting to me now. I am very interested in what we know from looking at another person, aside from what they say, just how they are, who they are, and what they are at a particular time.